bathtub to the DUI laws of today, drinking has changed dramatically over a few thousand years, but it's never gone out of style. Less than a lifetime ago, during Prohibition, bartenders were outlaws. Ruthless and scarred, the drinks they served rough and harsh and unrefined, as if stirred with the sulfur-stained steel barrels kept loaded below the bar. Today, ranging from neon-signed pitkeepers to tuxedo-clad bar chefs, the basic philosophy remains. We invite alcohol to take varying degrees of the edge off the world, and it is the bartender's job to guide you along the way. A good bartender is knowledgeable of his products and, time allowing, makes suggestions to suit a customer's palate, while at the same time recognizing their responsibility to keep people from falling completely over the edge. Friend, therapist, mixologist, bouncer, peacemaker, peeping Tom, simultaneously a hired leader and the last life raft one can hope to cling to before drifting off into the sea of total inebriation. There's a great deal more to being a good bartender than the obvious mechanical proficiency mixing drinks. Why do so many college graduates with degrees across the board prefer the bar? Is it the similarities to being on the stage, the quick cash, the camaraderie? I'm often asked when I'm going to get a real job. My response, I already have one. I'm the guardian of the fringe between sobriety and drunkenness, inhibition and exhibition, order and chaos. Tip me a few dollars and I'll make sure you get home safely. Even hold open the taxi door. Stiff me consistently, and I still will, but it might be in the back of a police car. What follows is a collection of observations over the span of 3 years in one of the most interesting restaurant environments ever encountered, interspersed with a series of essays allowing insight into how life is lived behind the bar. So, what'll it be?